Honorable Chairperson and honorable colleagues, I pray that and all Ugandans accept my sincere apology.
The embattled Minister for Karamoja Affairs, Mary Goretti Chitutu, appeared before Parliament's Committee on Presidential Affairs for the second time, which is probing the relief iron sheets scandal. The minister admitted that the iron sheets meant for the vulnerable people of Karamoja were distributed without proper guidelines. She claimed this is because she was not guided well.
That your mother and your brother have been selling iron sheets. Set those people free. Not in bad faith. I imagine what now, your family is going through.
Now, Honorable Chair, maybe that one I can also give you, because I've never gone there. I also hear it. I've actually
did
not
you
gone
deliver
home.
Iron sheets to those people?
Well, that was part of the donation for a school. And it was being stored.
Oh, okay. So, did
so
you?
That
I
one I need to get for more information.
Confirm.
Without proper guidance, some iron sheets meant for Karamoja region were given outside the region in response to requests. This could have been an oversight, but now that guidance has been given, this will not recur. Any inconveniences and embarrassments caused is highly regretted.
Chitutu said she will present a separate statement to the president and the entire executive in regard to the same.
My commitment to serving Uganda as a whole, and the Minister of Karamoja Affairs in particular, is unwavering. Honorable Chairperson and honorable colleagues, I pray that and all Ugandans accept my sincere apology.
However, her excuses were met with resistance in the committee, questioning the minister on how she gave out iron sheets without following proper guidance on relief distribution.
Minister has tendered in her apology. And her apology, to me, is not coming at the right time. It will dematerialize our investigation. First of all, we need detailed information from the minister on who received iron sheets, how many did each one of them receive, and then she respond to the question that we raise.
Minister's response looks half naked, because I wonder how the whole ministry and all government can ask for the supplementary in response of the challenges in Karamoja without a police guideline of how such supplementary budget is going to be implemented in that area. That one leaves us in courts.
MPs asked Chitutu to explain how some OPM-branded iron sheets found their way into the private hardware stores belonging to her relatives.
These iron sheets were purchased. They are meant for a particular purpose. So we would like to know under what circumstances people made requests for those particular iron sheets. And if necessary, you could avail us with those letters that the members submitted to request, and we understand how they could turn into beneficiaries.
The Honorable Minister is a senior minister and has served in many capacities before the Ministry of Karamoja Affairs. When she says she distributed without proper guidance, from whom does she want to get guidance for this particular supplementary budget or for the issuing of iron sheets?
The minister was overwhelmed by the questions and asked for more time to present a detailed report on the beneficiaries in a closed session without camera. This after she was put under oath. But the prayer was rejected by the committee on grounds that the beneficiaries are already in the press.
For the beneficiaries, Honorable Chair, I request that possibly I will give to you the information in confidence, not on the media. And secondly, when I said that I was not guided, normally the head of the technical teams, that's the PS, is always supposed to be guiding ministers, and I did not receive that.
You know, we were donation, because it never appeared in any of our documents when we asked the president for this supplementary. that there will be a word called donation. Let's let the minister say, I actually pilfered the hands of Karamoja. I stole them and gave some other people.
Geoffrey Seramba, the undersecretary in the office of the prime minister, told the committee that 80,000 iron sheets were procured for Karamoja, but the committee questioned him for inflating the unit cost. This was after she disclosed that each iron sheet cost government 79,000 shillings.
The gauge 28 pre-painted, we purchased it in the region 79,000 to 85,000. Yes.
That is not a specific amount.
In terms of pieces or in terms of square meters? Because what I know in most of these factories, these such iron sheets are sold in terms of what? Square meters.
The committee also interfaced with the Minister for Disaster Preparedness, Hilary Onek. Report by Fred Kajubi for the news at Parliament.